the line, ma'am.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes?
Mr. President?
Yes.
Mr. President,
hello, dear. How are you?
I am fine, Mr. President, but I am overcome with emotion, really. I don't see how you could have done
it. Well, I just thought we had to do it because there's so much at stake that one little person like me didn't.
You know you aren't one little person.
Well, I've got 9 months now to do nothing except I won't spend one moment doing anything except trying to find peace. And I thought that I just thought I had to do it.
Well, I just want to tell you that my affection
is dead.
And I want you to tell
Lady
how much I love her.
I sure will, dear. And I think it's awfully nice of you to call.
Well, I'm just, if I can hardly talk.
Everything will be better, and we'll have a lot of time to devote to what's really important. And after 37 years, you learn what is important. And I hope not. I don't want it to be. Sure will. I'll let you talk to her. Wait just a second.
Hello?
Bruce?
Yes.
It's Abigail.
Yes.
Milwaukee. And I think so shaken. I don't know what to do, but I just want to tell you that I remember the time we were in kind of broken pictures. You know? Yes.
Well, it's simply a matter of, I know that this takes 18 hours a day, as it is, and still all not done that you want to get done.
I know.
And it is not possible to add on the hours and the days that primaries would take, or a campaign would take, and do the fair job, the great job that this place deserves. So one has to make a choice. Well, you're sweet to call, and particularly when you have boys out there, when you feel pretty darn close to all 500,000 of them and hear from a whole lot of them, and you're just about to get two out there yourself, you don't think much about politics.
I know that, and I just think that it's very noble and I just want you to find it.
Well, thank you for calling, and I think you're sweet to do it.